Hi everyone, welcome to the Hall Wines Happy Hour. My name is Kathryn Hall. We have a wonderful show for you today. My guest is Giacomo Gianniotti, and Giacomo and I are going to be tasting one of my favorite wines. We're going to have the Montagna Cabernet. If you haven't had it, we don't make that much of it. Treat yourself to do it. It's really a wonderful wine. So let's bring on Giacomo. So many things to ask him about, and And while we're waiting for him to come, Giacomo, are you out here? Because I will find you. While we're waiting for him, know that our tasting rooms are open. We are ready for you, and I see you, Giacomo. And looking forward to having you come on. So it is really beautiful in Napa Valley these days. And welcome.
Thank you so much.
I am so glad that you're here. So cheers. We're going to have a little bit. We're going to talk about this wine.
A little happy hour.
We need to start. Right. You can't have happy hour and not have a sip. So Giacomo, you are talking to us from Los Angeles, I think.
Yeah.
But you are, your heritage is truly international. You are Canadian, part Italian. Which are you more? Are you more Italian, more Canadian, or what do you feel?
You know, I mean, relatively speaking, I definitely spent more of my life in Canada because we immigrated to Canada when I was about 6 years old. And then I would spend the summers there, so in Italy. So I've spent more time in Canada, but I think because life has taken me far from Italy, where I grew up and the place that I call, you know, my hometown, I long for it more because I've been taken from it. And you know, growing up and starting a career and work has taken me all over, and I haven't had a ton of time to spend in my motherland of Italy. So when I go, it's a treat, it's a pleasure, it's an enormous privilege. So I definitely feel more connected to Italy because I feel like I don't get to be there as much as I'd like to, and I miss it.
Well, those of us who have so loved you on Grey's Anatomy know that you speak Italian beautifully, and so that's really wonderful. I want to say to all of your fans who are joining, and there's so many who are coming on, and I'm sure you are seeing all the hearts that are coming up constantly. You all, I am just as excited as you are to have Giacomo with us today. But anyway, Giacomo has said that he will answer some questions, so get your questions in the queue and we will take those as we are going along. So anyway, let me start off with some questions. So what is it like? Here you are with your seven seasons on Grey's Anatomy. Do you miss the people? Did you bond? I mean, what's it like? All of a sudden, you're just like gone.
Yeah, it's been an incredible journey. You know, Grey's Anatomy has given me so much. It's helped me grow as an actor, as an artist. It's certainly given me a large platform for social media, which has really beautifully partnered with, you know, charity work and a lot of the giving back that I do for our homeless youth here in Los Angeles. Now, before I sort of became well-known or famous or, you know, on some big TV show, I was still doing those things. I was volunteering, I was, you know, but nobody knew about me. So when I sort of rang that bell to say, you know, hey, can you guys donate? It was like 10 people listening to me. So now it's closer to 3 million. And over the years, I've been able to raise, you know, over $100,000 for my friend's place because all of you guys, of all the fans who follow me and who get engaged with the causes that I get engaged with. So that's been another great sort of byproduct of Grey's Anatomy. And then this year I got to direct an episode of Grey's Anatomy.
Which was fabulous. Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.
So that's, you know, been another way for me to grow in a different part. part as an artist that I'm kind of now carving out a career as a director and being able to explore that further. And so Grey's Anatomy has just been this amazing kind of family that just champions artists. And we've had all kinds of people on the show over the years that started as a PA, then became a writer, then became a producer and an actor who directed. And so they're just very welcoming of people, you know, changing their forms or changing their artistry. So it's just been a very supportive place to grow as an artist.
It really has been. I am loving all these comments and all the hearts, and it's just so great.
Canada, hello Canada.
Yeah, and Canada's on, Argentina's here. I mean, we've got so many places in the house, so this is just the best. So as a symbol of how important this was, it seems to me it's a symbol. You got a tattoo, right? Didn't you?
I did, yes. Yeah. It's on my wrist.
But yeah,
my second. Put this up here.
So, ta-da! Yes, and that is.
But yeah, it's 2250, which was my character's time of death. But I mean, if you didn't know that, you wouldn't know. I mean, the number doesn't have a meaning unless you give it a meaning. And so to me, it just means sort of that, like, all beautiful things come to an end. And so everything should be appreciated. Life, obviously. But I mean, you can relate it to a million different things. It could be a beautiful job. It could be a summer. It could be love, romance. That, you know, all beautiful things come to an end. But that doesn't mean that something beautiful is also around the corner that could be just as amazing and just incredible and beautiful. So just a reminder of that.
So one door closes and another one opens.
Yeah.
And so you are already directing. And one of the questions that has come through, and I'm sorry I didn't catch your name as it was coming on, but it was, what's your next step? So what are you planning? Can you tell us what you're working on now, what you're going to be doing?
Yeah, I'm shooting a series called From Scratch, which is all about this young African-American girl's journey to Florence to study art and everything that happened and transpired after that. And it's a memoir of this amazing author called Tembi Locke. It was part of Reese Witherspoon's Hello Sunshine.
The book club. Oh, wow.
And so her book club and production company has now, you know, got the rights to it and produced it, and we're shooting it. So it's this beautiful, beautiful story about this woman's kind of journey to Florence, Italy, where she meets the love of her life, the Sicilian man, and then they come back to LA. So it shoots in LA and in Florence. So I shot the LA part, and I think in July I'll be heading to Florence to finish it off for some of our exteriors, which I'll be able to get to see my family, which I haven't seen in like 2 years. So I'm very excited.
Yay! Yeah, that's really exciting. Wait a minute. So are you the Sicilian? Because I got to say, you don't look Sicilian to me.
No, I don't play the Sicilian. I play sort of, a lot of women say that you got to kiss a lot of frogs to get to the prince, right? So I'm one of the frogs, I guess.
You're one of the frogs.
I'm a stepping stone to the prince.
Oh, if that's not going to hook everybody into watching a show that Giacomo says that he's the frog in, we're there. Okay. Yeah. So, but so to come back for just a second to Grey's Anatomy. I thought that scene on the beach with Meredith at the end was just, it was beautiful. And I'd love to hear you just talk a little bit about that, because you sort of touched on it a little bit earlier about all good things come to an end. This was a very good thing in your life. Many more good things are coming, but that must have been a very poignant day.
Yeah, I think it was, you know, it was my last scene. It was my last scene with Ellen. And, you know, there was this weird duality of, you know, in the beginning when I started on the show, I felt like I was hitting all these firsts, like the first time, you know, being on a big show like that. And the first time I became a series regular on a show, the first time I, you know, got to sit behind the camera and, you know, talk to the directors. I was a young actor coming from mostly theater that I was doing in Canada. So I was hitting so many firsts. And so at the sort of end of my journey on Grey's Anatomy, and that day especially, it was sort of like all these lasts, like the last time I'm going to be acting with Ellen as this character, the last time I'll be in an OR, the last time I'm acting with this actor that I love and appreciate. And so it was just like every scene was just, I was just so present and so dialed in because I was just so aware that it was the last time that I was going to, you know, now I'm not dying. The people I'm working with are dying. We're great friends. We're going to catch up some wine, probably some home wine. But, you know, but our characters, this is the last time they're going to meet. That's the last time I'm going to meet this actor as this character in this moment. And so it was sad because I've really, you know, enjoyed working with all these people over the years. And so it was emotional, you know what I mean? Because I think there's a lot of commonality between DeLuca and myself because DeLuca was saying goodbye. DeLuca was sort of letting go of this person that he was so fond of. And I also was kind of letting go of Ellen. And sort of mourning the fact that I wouldn't be working with her anymore and in that capacity. So it was very easy to kind of be emotional and be sad and be, you know, conscious of all those things going on.
It was so real and so there.
So and also, a beautiful beach. It didn't suck to shoot there. It was okay. We're always trapped in an OR in the hospital. It's not the most beautiful, you know, thing. But, you know, that day we got to be on a beach with the sunset. I was like, this is all right. I can dig this.
So cool. Where is that beach?
It's called, what is it called? It's somewhere kind of like in I think it's Palos Verdes.
You ever been? Oh, okay.
There? Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That area.
Just a little bit north of LA there.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh my gosh. Okay. Let's see. We need to, okay. I'm loving all these comments. I can't read it in Italian. And I thought that was Italian. We just went through. Okay. Well, let's see. Let me find you a good question. So we had one question here that came back. You touched just a little bit about your philanthropy, and I happen to know, and I don't, maybe everybody else does too, but you describe yourself on Instagram in a variety of ways, and one of them is philanthropy, and I'm just philanthropist, and that's such a beautiful thing to be able to use your fame, your celebrity, to be able to help the causes like you were talking about. But you've also had a chance on the show really to elevate the awareness on some really important social issues, you know? And I just, that must have made the, just being on the show that much more real, much more important.
Definitely, yeah. I think, you know, as a writer, I think, you know, on a show, you try to give the character on your show something of an edge, right? Something that's their thing. When Krista Vernoff, stepped in for Shonda Rhimes to run our show, she sort of sat all our actors down, including myself, and she's like, what's going on? What do you want out of this character? What's missing? And I'm like, it was the first kind of two or almost 3 years that I'd been on the show, and I just said, I feel like he's missing something. I feel like he's not three-dimensional. I want to develop something about him. I don't know exactly what it is, but, you know, there's something kind of missing. And so we went a lot of back and forth, and then we ended up planting the seed in a much previous season where my father comes, and we see that he has a mental illness history of bipolar and has kind of blown up his life and was never really truly diagnosed or helped or had the amount of support around him to thrive. And that planted a seed for later, because it's hereditary at times, Andy. For DeLuca himself to develop bipolar and start his mental health journey, and discovering all that, discovering, you know, really big lows in depression, highs in mania. And ever since that sort of started to come out about my character, it opened up a big conversation within the Grey's Anatomy fan community about mental health and mental illness and stigmas around it, and how, you know, I think we've come a long way, but there's still a lot of work to do around the stigmas. of mental health. So I think the more they're talked about, the more representation there is on TV shows and films, the more we can kind of break down those stigmas, have these people really just seen as human beings who are capable of love, capable of having amazing careers, capable of doing all sorts of extraordinary things, even though they're battling an invisible force. It's just been a great opportunity for me to reach out to people, to talk to people. I've had so many messages from fans all over the world. And a lot of them that you know, are suffering, a lot of them that have bipolar and have said, you know, I really appreciated the way you guys and the writers all kind of put the story together and helped me see, you know, what I was going through, or helped my family to understand me better, or whatever it was. And that was by far the most gratifying part of the 7 years of being on the show, that I feel like people felt seen, they felt understood. That's why we do what we do. You know, so at least I believe that. So, yeah.
Well, here's to you. And let's talk just a minute about this wine, okay, that we've been having. So I said this actually before you came on, but this is the one wine we make that has an Italian name. It's Montagna, which of course, Giacomo, you know, but it means mountain in Italian. And we named it that because the vineyard that this comes from is very, it's very special. We make very little wine out of there. We would love to make more, but there just isn't more vineyard to make it from. But it's all 1,800 feet above the valley floor. So that means, and it's above the fog line, which is rare to be able to grow grapes above the fog line. So what you get is this very cool climate, but at the same time, additional sun, because the sun isn't blocked from the fog during the day. And the result is a wine that has this just beautiful sort of plum, dark cherry flavors, but it's very rich and dense, but it's not a heavy in your mouth.
It's wine. Delicious. It's really, really delicious.
You guys definitely
check it out.
I'm
all
so
about
glad.
Great wines, but this is really an exceptional wine you guys should check out.
Thank you. Well, someone just wrote something, I think in Italian. I think that was, it was positive. But good. And if it was, then you don't have to tell me.
So no, because the vineyard is sort of on a mountain, right? That's why you called it Montagna.
Montagna, exactly. It's on a mountain. That's why. So anyway, so this is the wine and this is the Montagna wine. So now I have a little trivia game that you said that you would be willing to play. You obviously don't know the answers,
but
this is it's a Grey's Anatomy trivia. And we don't want to put you too much on the spot. And I thought it would be fun if your fans can help you. So if you need some help.
Yeah. So feel free when she's asking these questions, if you guys want to chime in on the bottom and help me out, I'll appreciate that. But I promise that I'll only look to the things if I need to. I'll do my best to answer myself.
Okay. Yeah.
I won't cheat.
Look up. Well, we're going to watch your eyes. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. So here we go.
Okay. See if I don't look down.
All right. Okay. Oh, you know what else we should do? Let's, if you get a wrong question, you have to take a sip. Okay.
Okay. Good.
Why not? It's not a bad duty. Okay. All right, first question. Who were the original five interns?
Well, Justin Chambers wasn't in the pilot. I remember him telling me that one day when we were on set. So that would have to be...
character names.
Christina Yang, Meredith Gray.
Good.
Meredith Gray... O'Malley and Izzy. And I mean, I could say Justin Chambers, Alex Karev, but was it Alex Karev?
Yes.
Those are the five, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Did you say George?
Yeah.
You
said O'Malley.
George?
Yeah. George
okay,
O'Malley.
Good.
Yeah.
Well, hey.
Okay. I got it right.
All right. Well, one down. thousands to go. Okay, here we go. What organ did Meredith give to her father?
Oh, God. I'm going to need some fan help on that one. Fan help. What organ did Meredith give to her father?
Come on, guys.
Come on. Uh-oh.
Okay, drinking... I'm a fan, but I don't think I should give it
liver.
To you. Just, you
the
know.
Liver?
Yes, it was the liver.
Thank Woo-hoo. You. Now I'm going to hold on. I'm going to scroll back up because I want to give credit where credit is due. Sophie Lynn and Liz V. Scott. Thank you so much for bailing me out of that one.
Okay, cool. All right. Where was yours and Meredith's first kiss? Your first kiss.
Well.
On screen, yes.
Of course. we had a scene in the elevator where we like almost kissed. So I don't know if that counts, but I think that was sort of our first almost.
Okay. Kiss. I was sort of thinking of one that was sort of outside in a garden and you're coming over a bridge at the wedding.
Yes, that was
okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Sort of like
I'll give it to
a drunken yes. Yes, the yep. wedding. Yes, that was our first
okay. Game.
It was kind of messy, and DeLuca was drunk, and he sort of went for it and misjudged a situation completely. But I guess that was their first kiss. Yeah.
Yeah, I totally love that. Actually, when you said, "Oh my God, did you? Am I firing?" That was just so well done. I thought it was a great line, but also I just thought the way you delivered it was just beautiful.
Thank you.
Yeah. Okay, next. Where was the plane going before the plane crashed?
I'm going to need to call in my fan help on that one.
Where was the plane going before the plane crashed? Come on, you guys.
Where was the plane going? Come on, tell me, guys. Idaho Falls? Boise?
That was pretty close. That's pretty close.
Boise Hospital?
Boise.
Okay, there we go.
Woohoo!
These fans. Nice. You guys just come in right away. Hold on.
This is...
Well Matthew, Grays, X-Fairy, Emma, Gary 13. Thank you guys so much for that.
Oh, nice. Okay. What was the original name of the show going to be?
Oh, I think that's above my grade there. I don't know. I don't know if I ever heard that story. I feel like I might have like heard whisperings of that story, but I don't think I ever actually heard what it was.
Huh.
So
I don't know the story behind it. I just know the answer.
Okay, well, I guess let's take a drink.
That's it. Yeah. Okay, take a drink. The original name was going to be Complications.
Complications?
Yeah.
Oh, well, thank God they went with Grey's Anatomy.
No kidding. Okay. What was the original name of the hospital before Gray Sloan?
Seattle Grays, wasn't it?
Yes.
Yeah.
Great. Okay. Which country is Christina currently residing in?
Oh, God. I think it's Switzerland, isn't it?
It is Switzerland. Whoa. That's good. Yeah. Okay. Now.
What am I like? I only got two wrong. Two or three.
Yeah. Oh, no, you only got one wrong, I think.
Not two and two.
But anyway, whatever. Okay. I think this is totally A-plus material here. What are Meredith's kids' names?
Sorry, you just cut out for a second.
I'm sorry. The names of Meredith's four kids. What are they?
Zola, Bailey, Ellis, and... Zola, Bailey, Ellis... Zola, Bailey, Ellis. Three. Four?
There's four.
What am I missing?
Well, I think there's four.
Bailey, Ellison, Silva. Yeah, I don't think four.
Okay, maybe
Are you talking about is Scout the name?
I have Derek. No.
No.
No. That's
her,
moving on. One last question. Okay, and this is just so you were on seven seasons. There have been so many amazing actors that have come and gone on the show. Was there anyone with whom you did not overlap, who you would have enjoyed working with? Anyone in particular that you would prefer to have overlapped with?
Oh boy. Well, you know what? This is, I guess, maybe a little bit, maybe not what you're asking, but is what you're asking at the same time. Once Denzel Washington directed one of my episodes, and although he wasn't an actor on the show, he was certainly a part of the show and directed. And I certainly would have loved to have been in a scene with Denzel Washington and traded blows with him on screen. That would have been really, really, really cool. But even having the chance to be directed by him was very cool.
So, well, we are sadly out of time. You've just been so generous with your time, Giacomo. And
this was lovely.
Well, thank you. Thank you so much for being with us today, with me today, and with all of your fans who have obviously just had so much fun, and as have I. But before you take off, any last words or thoughts you want to share with everybody?
Oh, boy. I guess just to follow you guys, follow Hall Wines and go buy some of their wine. It's so delicious, especially this one. The Montagna is so delicious. Check them out. If you've never been to Napa before, it's a beautiful, beautiful place to visit. No matter what time of year it is, it's always a great time. And I know travel is a little restricted right now, but I'm sure hopefully soon things can be a little bit more open. We can all travel again, and I hope you'll go visit Hall.
Well, that's what a sweet thing to say. You have just been, it has just been such a joy to have you here. And I am really grateful for your time. And I can't wait to have you come up to Napa again and visit us. And we'll see you in person. But in the meantime, cheers, Giacomo. And thank you so much.
Okay. And thank you guys to all the fans that joined in for this. This was really amazing that you guys all joined in. Thank you so much. Thank you for helping me with the questions. I appreciate that very much as well. And have a great day, guys. Thanks for having me.
Bye-bye, Giacomo.
Okay. Take care.
Bye-bye. Well, what fun. So, everybody, we've got many more wonderful shows lined up. We are here every week. Follow us to see the programs and see who we've got coming on each week, and you can get all the information you need. We've got a wonderful sale for a summer going on right now at Hall Wines. You can check out that on our website, hallwines.com. And by the way, it's National Wine Day. So not a bad way to celebrate with John Giacomo. So thank you, everybody, so much. I look forward to seeing you, hopefully in Napa Valley and definitely here online. So in the meantime, till we meet again, stay healthy and sip up.